Today we're going to talk about a very important topic, but one that is seldom discussed. It is, in fact, where the audience has their first impression of you and their last impression of you while you're on the stage, and that is the concert bow. There are as many different bows as there are people, and there are different styles. You may recognize one that you currently do. You may see one that you didn't think of that you'd like to try on for size. So without further ado, here we go. The first bow that we're going to talk about is called the duck. And it's an effective bow to make sure that the audience knows that they are not allowed to leave while you're bowing. So as you're coming out for your third or fourth or fifth encore bow, you need to make sure that the audience knows that you know that they know that you know that they know that they're not supposed to leave. If they're sitting or they're standing, preferably cheering, that's fine, but you need to make sure that they're not heading for the exit, so you need to keep your eye on them. And that's where the duck becomes so effective, because they see you staring at them, and even maybe judging them a little bit, if they are in fact doing anything but cheering for you. The duck is a perfect way to make sure that you're asserting your dominance over your audience. Now, the next bow that we're going to talk about is called the straddle. Now, let's just imagine that you have performed Debussy and you have lifted your audience to new heights of artistic ecstasy, and yourself for that matter. You've just completed that piece of music and you need to make sure that you've got your bearing, your footing on the ground, because if you don't, you might fall over. It would totally ruin the experience. So the straddle is something where you take your legs and you put them maybe around shoulder distance or even further, just to make sure that you are firmly planted on the stage and that they're comfortable knowing that you are not going to lift off again, or that you are not going to fall over, or that you're not going to somehow evaporate. The straddle is the best way to accomplish this for your audience, because it's, you know, you need to make sure that they aren't worried about you. A close relative of the straddle is something that we call look behind you. Now, this is a technique that you can use where you bend over as far as possible and you look backwards between your legs to make sure that the conductor or maybe your pianist or anybody else isn't about to hit you over the head with a music stand. This is actually a safety technique so that you can make sure that while you're bowing, no one is going to club you. Some people even call it look at your butt or look at your ass, but the reality is you're looking behind you to make sure that you're safe. Now, over the last, I would say, 20 years or so, since the beginning of the new millennium, there have been a couple of new types of bows that I've seen that have become kind of popular and even hip. The first one we're going to talk about is called the what's up. Now, the what's up is what you want to do when you don't care about your audience at all, and you want them to feel like you could take them or leave them. You don't care whether they came, you don't care if they are clapping, you don't care about anything, actually. You don't need to be there, and you want to make sure that they know that, yeah, it's cool. A close relative of the what's up is the nod. Now, the nod is something where you want to acknowledge your audience as they're clapping for you that, yes, indeed, you are as good as they think you are, because you've just taken them to a totally different artistic zip code of awesomeness, and you want to acknowledge that as they clap, yes, they're right to clap for you. So the nod is a terrific way to both acknowledge your audience and give them affirmation that, in fact, they are right to be clapping for you. And the final member of this family of bows is called the walking bow. This is when you both want to acknowledge your audience, but you've got somewhere else to be. So as the audience is clapping, you basically just walk off the stage and acknowledge them and then never come back, because honestly, it's cool. You got another gig down at the Edison, you got to do a recording or whatever it is, and you need to get off the stage and get down there because your time is more important than their time. So the walking bow is a way to both acknowledge your audience and get to your next gig at the same time. So if the concert has gone overtime, you've either played a solo that's too long, or the conductor took too long to get on and off the stage, or most often is the case, the audience has clapped for a good solid 20 minutes for you, and you've come on and off the stage at least a half dozen, maybe 12 times. So when the concert has gone on that long, the best thing to do is just call the peace out. You got no more time for them. You're done. So rather than bowing, just leave. Just leave. It's the easiest way to acknowledge the fact that you're finished and that they should just go home. Or they can stay, you don't care, but you're leaving. Now, a lot of contemporary music performers or performance artists, they've just played a piece of music. The audience isn't even quite sure if the piece is over yet, if it's time for them to clap. So what you need to do, the best way to handle this as a performer, is do what we call the deer in the headlights. You just look at them. You don't let them know that the piece is over, they're not quite sure what to do, and you are holding them in the grip of your performing excellence. So the deer in the headlights, where you just want to make sure that the whole situation is as awkward for the audience as possible, just look at them. You don't need to bow. You don't even need to acknowledge that the piece is over. Now, sometimes you want to do a combination of the deer in the headlights and the peace out. So where you look at the audience, they're not quite sure what's going on, and then you just leave. Deer in the headlights is a very effective way to create an atmosphere of extreme discomfort for your audience. The next pair of bows are specific to environments where you're in an ensemble, band, orchestra, or even chamber music. The first one we're going to talk about is called the music shift. Here's a situation where the audience is clapping. They could be friends or family or a musical agent or the President of the United States. It doesn't matter. What matters is that you take the music that you just played, you put it behind all of the stack of music that you're about to play, and you make sure that the next piece of music is sitting up in front of you so you're ready to play it. That's more important. It's always more important than looking at and acknowledging your audience. Forget it. They can wait. You need to make sure that your music is set. And the second form of ensemble bow is something that we call make plans with your neighbor. So the audience is clapping, the conductor is turning around and bowing to the audience or acknowledging the ensemble. That's really not as important as talking to the person next to you or in front of you or behind you to make sure that you all have agreed on where you're going to go after the concert, whether it's a bar or to a party. Another thing that you can be doing is talking to your neighbor about the things that they screwed up as they just performed that you heard, and you want to make sure that they know that you heard them screw up. Or alternatively, you're apologizing for when you made a double page turn and you started playing about 3 minutes further in the piece than the rest of the ensemble. That's the perfect time for that. So that's called the making plans with your neighbor, but it could just as easily be called acknowledging your neighbor's mistake or apologizing for your mistake. But overall, we call making plans with your neighbor. That's just what it's been called my entire career as a clarinet player. So I hope this was helpful for you. And for those of you who are not keen to satire, this entire video was a joke. I know for some of you who watched my different types of performance movement videos, there was some question of whether I was serious or not. I am not serious. The reality of bowing is this. Kidding aside, you want to make sure that you acknowledge your audience. Look at them, make eye contact, maybe even say thank you or mouth thank you. Appreciate your audience. They just spent the last however long sitting in their seats, not on their phones, hopefully, watching you do your thing. They clap, they're appreciative, they are supportive. So you need to turn around and thank the heck out of them for being there for you. The audience is the most important part of a concert environment. You are creating community by how you perform, whether you talk about the piece, how you perform the piece, and what you do after the piece is an acknowledgement of the importance of live music. Because if you treat the audience like crap, they're not going to show up the next time. And if they don't show up the next time, there are going to be fewer and fewer concerts. So pay attention to your audience. If you're in an ensemble, face the front and smile. Don't shift your music. Don't talk to your neighbor. Don't look like you are a deer in the headlights. Don't do any of those things. Acknowledge, smile, and appreciate the fact that they sat there and watched you, okay? So all of that other stuff was a joke. What I just said is for real. I hope this was helpful. For band directors, I hope this was even more helpful, and we will see you next time. Thanks for watching. Bye.